Welcome Leon from Athletico to talk about staying healthy and not hurting yourself when you're moving. Summertime, a lot of people are moving, they're boxing up things and heading out. So what's the best way to make sure I don't end up with a back pain that'll bother me for a long time?
Well, first of all, if you have a little bit of a back pain, the good news is Athletico offers complimentary injury screening. So if anything ever happens, if you're feeling sore, if you're having any pain whatsoever, come by to one of our clinics and one of our therapists will be sure to check you out.
So they just kind of give you a quick exam and tell you what you could do to get better.
Exactly. And we let you know, hey, this is wrong or that's wrong. Or we'll just point you to the right direction too to get everything squared away and get you back up on your feet.
Great. And you're all over St. Louis. I know you've got a lot of locations.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. Now to get into the actual moving. Now, before you start off, you want to make sure you get everything organized, laid out. You know, an easy way to do it is just by organize things by weight. You know, whether it's a simple making it an H or an
sure.
L for something that's light, something like that. Another thing you want to do is to start off with just some pre-warm-up stretches just to get your body ready for the move that's about to happen. A squat technique that I like, you just kind of come down here, touch your toes a little bit, and then you come back up and extend. Do that a couple of times. That'll help warm up your hips as well as your knees a little bit. Another one that you can do is you can also lay down on your back, maybe bring your knees into your chest just to loosen up your lower back just a tiny bit as well.
So that would help prevent an injury from just jumping right into it?
Yeah. Okay. You know, if you jump right into, your body isn't prepared, you might kind of do this little thing. You know, you don't want to lift like that. When you are lifting, you want to make sure you bring your body as close to the object as possible. Now, this is a little higher. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get as close to it. I'm going to drop my knees. I'm going to carry it like this. And once I have it lifted, I want to keep it close to my body the entire time. I don't want to twist like this. I want to turn together. I don't want to strain my back.
Okay.
So put it down exactly the same way you picked it up.
What are some of the common injuries people have from lifting the wrong way?
Yeah, so the biggest thing I see in the clinic is people that hold their breath a lot when they lift. You know, when you hold your breath, things tighten up. That increases your risk of getting a strain, a hernia, or the nasty injuries that we don't want to have. That's for sure. That'll put a hiccup in your day.
Right, people, they take that deep breath. All right.
Yeah, that's when all those injuries start happening. Those are some of the most common injuries I see in the clinic from a day-to-day basis. You know, just people lifting. Probably the worst lifting technique I see is this one here. And they're straining. And then, whoops, they'll be seeing me for a couple of weeks. So
I mean, when you get an injury like that, it can last a long time. So
those
are some good tips. Leon from Athletico, thank you for coming in. Appreciate
no problem
it. At all. We'll be right back on Fox 2 News Saturday morning. Stay with us.